98% of what the major labels have released have failed, and they've spent billions of dollars in marketing promoting them. What's changed is it used to traditionally be three media outlets that would expose music. It would be commercial radio, television, hear much music, MTV, and print magazines. And that was it. And you had two sets of gatekeepers, the A&R person signing into a record label, and the media outlet looking at what's being released by the labels to decide what they're going to expose, with a rare exception. Now it is democratized, and I say hooray as opposed to phooey, but I think it's a cool thing, and what happens is you now have direct access for everything being available for consumers and music fans to buy and share and so forth, but you also have direct access to the media outlets, which is a good thing and a overwhelming thing.
That's why I say phooey.
It's overwhelming because there are a million websites out there and products and services, and which ones are meant to pull it, and frankly, there isn't one. Patrick is right, and you're right, and all, you yourself. I wouldn't have a job if the musicians in here didn't give me one. And we all work for you, and it's your art that moves this entire industry. But there's not one thing over the other which will ultimately make you a star. It's got to start with music. Be Rebecca Black. You guys know Rebecca Black? Okay. Anyone know? You should know. So Rebecca, I just wanted to, because it's really intimate here. Rebecca Black, I think it was 14 or 15.
Yeah.
So basically her mom bought her the appearance of being on a record label. They made a video. Well, the video has almost 100 million views now on YouTube, and it took off and moved into the top 20 on iTunes. Good for her. I'm not the biggest fan of the song, but it's moving. Whatever. the point is, stuff like that does happen, and who the hell knows what's going to cause it. That being said, I think that you're right, and you're all right. It should be a very defined set of things that you're going to do. Right? You shouldn't try to take on everything. First thing I think you should do is the work, and it's called work for a reason. Right? It sucks to do, but educate yourself. When I started my record label, I had to do everything, and I'm really glad I stuffed the envelopes and took out the garbage, because then when I ended up doing deals with record labels, when I negotiated, I understood what rights I was giving up and what rights I wasn't, what work I wanted to do, what work I didn't, and what the exchange was. You know, alright, I'll transfer rights to you in return for you doing A, B, C, and D, and that's reasonable or that's unreasonable. Once you get the foundation, you can then make educated decisions. I want to make my money off of live gigs. Okay, go to Eventful. Get the Eventful way to give away your music, build up your fame that way, but know what you're giving away. No, I want to sell my music. Okay, we'll understand what that means. I will gig for free in order to build up fame, and then I'll sell the music. I want to do both. I want to make money as the songwriter, and I don't care about the performance, not the recording itself. I just want to get placed into TV shows and films and make money off of public performances, like the guys from the band Friends, who had a song placed in the intro of that television show, and every single time that TV show has aired, they have made money as the songwriters, millions and millions of dollars. Right, so understand what they are, and then you can make educated decisions. I would say be wary of websites that charge you for possibility and charge you for the possibility. If you pay me money, we could maybe sign your record label. Hey, go fuck yourself, okay? that gets me, that's snake. But there's lots and lots of great services out there which won't charge you because we've come up with different business models. I'm one, I charge an upfront fee, but I do what I say. I'm not going to make you a star, I'll put your music on time. That's what I do. I don't promise anything else. So I do think things like Twitter are important, Facebook is important, I think your own web page is important. You know, you want to control what people see. When they go to Google and they type in your band name, do you want them going to Facebook? Or do you want them going to MySpace or your own homepage where you can give them the message you want them to get? Collect an email or a phone number so you can text them or email them with a call to action. Tell your fans what you want them to do. Think about yourself. When I was 16 years old, if Morrissey from the band The Smiths had emailed me or texted me, hey, we have a couple of tracks that we're considering putting on an album, you want to hear the demos? I would have been through the roof as I inhaled my clove cigarette. So think about what works on you, and then use that to collect your own fans.
Here's a really big question that comes up for me, and it's part of my whole phooey statement, is what's happened is the attention span, in fact. It's
what?
Yeah. Sorry. There are a bazillion songs on iTunes, right? It's great that your stuff is on iTunes. Who's going to find it? You're going to have to tell people about it. And people are inundated constantly with, oh, check my stuff out. Oh, you know, there are only so many hours in the day and so many like cycles that a person has as a consumer to really choose, oh, I'm going to go check out. And so it's like what Jeff is saying, you tell them what you want to do. Find a way to communicate with them directly. I think the direct channel is essential. Nothing's going to be sustainable without some kind of direct-to-fan interaction. Like Rebecca Black, she's great. She got like a gajillion hits on YouTube. What's going to happen with that in 2 years? How does it...
It's done.
You know, how do you make it sustainable? That's the question I'm trying to answer day in, day out. How does an artist create sustainable business in this industry today? And the only way to do that is you've got to involve the fans. You've got to give them a reason to know who you are and want to constantly check in with you. It's just, it's really a simple human dynamic because of the intentions. Because there's so much choice now. There's a lot more consumption now, but you've got a smaller window to really grab someone's attention. You got to do it more often.
Tweet about the debate last night if you wanted to. You can choose to alienate half the population.
Yeah, you did say that.
You know, and it's a really good point. What's interesting? You know, well, the right wing sucks. You know, click here. And if you take it back to your law, or the left wing, it's fantastic.
Because what we did in the other panel, where we all the different things that you're not, the other stuff.
Yeah, we talked about, I mean, one of the things that's I like bands do is they actually talk about other bands and other artists. And that is a really great camaraderie. So if there's artists that are similar to you, you know, instead of creating rivalry, you guys talk about each other, create lists on Twitter, say, hey, our friend's band's playing, or wow, did you hear this new record? If you talk about a band that's on Facebook that's similar to you without being kind of spammy, you don't want to like have it go all over their page. Like I've seen on Stone Temple Pilots, if you like Stone Temple Pilots, look at us. That's not what I'm talking about. But if you just like, you know, talk about other artists that are playing in your area or artists that are similar, they'll talk about you, especially on Twitter. So it's like a give and take type of thing. It's probably going to be the same type of fan, right? What else did we talk about?
If you talk really about things that you like, then it becomes less work. It becomes more about you.
If you're into, you know, the X competition, Ego X competition, or something like that, you, on the side, you're trying to like invent a new green energy, or you're into green energy, talk about it. Other people like green energy. You know, it will bring in fans from corners of the world that you didn't expect to.
Yeah, it's all about personality. And, you know, there's tons of rock bands that produce CDs every year and tour. But you know, you are a rock band who's also in green, and also for some reason, you know, toothpicks there every meal. Like then you have like more character. You might not get everybody, but you might get a solid fan base that kind of becomes friends with people. And it's like, you know, I'm friends with this person because they're interesting. And so if you stand out, then that helps you kind of rise above the noise. Obviously, there's tons of noise.
See, then you can tweet, do the short tweet, you know, roadkill is great to eat, right with the link. When they click on the link, it takes you to your blog where you've written an article about how fun it is right. To stop at your and then you can also on that blog have either the Nimbit widget or you know, link to your app or somewhere else where you get an email address for a free song. Now you've just captured an engaged person who likes what you like, who's interested, who got your music, and you can now communicate with them again. And you just set up the trap in a very positive way.
I have something to say about blogging, because I hate blogging. We constantly tell artists blog, and for those that can write, I think that's amazing, and they should do it. Maybe even lyrics. But if you have to think of something like kind of different, like I know an artist that doesn't like to really talk about a lot. So what he does is he just puts images up of whatever's on his mind. He does the research of like different images, different videos, and so I check back to his website all the time. Or I mean, he puts my website and on Facebook. Because I want to know what new image he's put up today. I'm happy to be interested in photography, so I look at, you can do it through lots of different channels and then, you know, put it out to Twitter or Facebook or whatever, but definitely keep it on your website.
If you don't want to write, just post a link to what you think is interesting to that thing, like not just a picture, like, oh, I read this article about, you know, the shit that's going on.
That's right.
That's what the Huffington Post did, and that's what the Drudge reported. These are news sites. They don't write any of their own content, just linking up to other people's stuff.
Yeah, I